Now he's going right underneath his ribs, real shallow, not too deep, leaving some meat on top of them. What that does, that lets us get to that belly meat that's underneath there as well. We'll take those ribs out. If we left them in, they cook to pieces. And what we like to do is we'll take them out and we'll put them in back in towards the end of the cook. That way we have a really good slab of ribs too. Almost cook them. It's almost like you don't want to overcook them. There's a lot of pieces of this hog that'll overcook the time it takes to get these big hams and shoulders done. The ribs will just be gone to pieces, but we can make them turn into some great rack of ribs by doing this to them. Also, it allows us to get some more rub down here below them. Taking this time on the front end really makes a big difference on the back end, other than just, you know, throwing some injection in it and throwing some rub on it and putting it on. If you really clean it up, put some effort in there, flip that side of ribs over and just look at them. That's what you call St. Louis trim spare ribs. That's how good it looks.
Take care of the small things on the front end, the big things take care of themselves.
You still have a rack of baby backs in there. Those would be called your loin ribs, and we leave those in because they'd be so small when you take them out. Wouldn't be any point in it, but we can still get to our loins right underneath there. Now he's going to go back and take the sinew membrane off his shoulder to get down to it so we can make a good bark on our shoulder. And that's what a lot, we can make bark on our whole hog just like we do our shoulder bark. It works the same way by taking the time to clean them up.